There are a lot of libraries which can help us generate PDF file, both in our Blazor application and also in our web API. I came across one package which is more efficient and with high performance, which is QuestPDF. This package or this library has a lot of features which can allow us to customize our footer, our header, and our page content itself. Let's see how we're going to introduce that or integrate it in our web API. So we're going to generate the PDF file in our API. After watching this video, if you're able to learn something new, then do not forget to put a thumbs up to this video. If you haven't subscribed, so you can do that so you can have more .NET content from this channel. I need to create a project. Actually, this library can be used in all .NET versions. I'm talking about 7, 8, and 9. But since I have .NET 9 as current, I'm going to integrate that in .NET 9. And it is the same step when you're using .NET 8 or 7. So I'm going to create a new project here with my Visual Studio 2022 or higher launched. And you know, we want to work on from our API. So let's go to create a web API project. So I create a project name, and you should also do so. And then .NET 9, as I told you, you can go in for any of the versions that you have. Let's use the current one. So in order for us to able to see the UI or the interface or interact with an API, you know that .NET 9 does not have Swagger inbuilt, right? Or integrated. So we need to use the Scala API doc. So we need to install this package. So in the NuGet package, let's install the Scala and also the QuestPDF. So we need two packages in order for this to work. So this is the package that you need, QuestPDF. Let's get this installed. So after we have this installed, let's go and install Scala as well. So now that we are done, let's go to our program.cs file. And in here, let's use the Scala. Now let's go to the controller and I'll try to generate a PDF. So let's create a private method which can be called in our endpoint. Now with this, we're going to return document. This document coming from PDF, QuestPDF.fluent, this one, not system.reflection, but at this one. So make sure you choose the correct one. And here we can have access to .create. Now with this, it needs a container because you know, with the PDF, let's assume talking about the page. The PDF page, that's the A4 sheet, right? Let's assume that is a page. It could be A4, it could be A3, it could be any page size, okay? We're going to specify that as well. Let's say this is a container that we're going to put all our work in. Now we need to extend this and configure some certain features here. First of all, we need a container as page. So let's have a container dot, then we have page. Now with this page, let's specify it here. Now, the first thing that we need to do here is we need a general settings which is going to apply to the entire A4. What do I say A4? Because you can choose A3. The entire page. Let's say there's an entire page. Okay, it could be A3, it could be A4, it could be any page size that you know. Now, we need that we can specify the page size and also we can specify the margin, the page color, and a default text style. There are a lot of features in there. Let's consider these four. Okay, so let's get them done. So once you have this page, we can say that this page dot size. Now talking about the page size here, and here we can use this page size, page sizes. So page sizes. Then with this page size, I think it should come from QuestPDF.helpers. So this is a helper class, and we can see we have from A0 up to all the page sizes. Yeah, we want to focus on A4, right? So that's an A4 page size. Okay, we are not done. This is going to apply to all. This is a page size. Aside from that, we can specify page.margin. Now this margin, we can say this is 2, and you want to set the unit of what? Centimeter. You can push it, you can expand it, you can do anything. Okay, so aside from that, let's also add one more. So page dot, not one more, page color. We want to set color dot white. You see, we have a lot of colors here. Let's maintain white. Okay. I'm not having, this should be colors from the helper, not this. Okay. Then the next thing that we need to do here, we can also set default text style. Okay. Now with this, we can say that you want to use the font size which cuts across or from the header to the footer. It means the header is part, the content is part, and also footer is part. So you want to set the font size, you want to set font color too, you can do that. And now with this, let's set this to 20. So this is going to apply to all. Now once you're done with this, let's go and now start with a header, because an A4 sheet, if you want to generate it, we need a header, content, and a footer, isn't it? So let's go. This is a page dot header. Now with this header, we want to dot test. Let's say, well, this is page header. This is going to be the header. Aside from that, we are not done. We can integrate under features. So here, we want to set a semi-bold. You can increase it. You can also set font size. Remember that here, we have already set the font size here for the page size. And here, we're going to override that. So this, we are saying the font size will be 20. But here, maybe we can integrate or we can override it and then make this header as what, 30, 36, and then we can also apply font color as well. Then we're gonna say colors, maybe dot blue, dot medium. You can set anyone, any of them based on how you want to format your PDF file. So that is what we need for the header. Now let's go and I'll work with the content. Then we come to the footer. So with the content, we say page.content. And we can also set padding, vertical padding. It is there. Then we can set one as unit centimeter. You can choose meters, can choose any based on how you want to format it as indicated earlier on. Then in here, we can specify the column. Now with this column is where we're going to specify our text. So here we need to expand that. And here we're going to say that x.spacing. So here, this is what we're doing from our header, from our, within the content, the number of text. It could be images, it could be text. Let's say the number of items that you have in the page, you want to space them. So this space is going to have an even space for all. So let's say the first one is done. Second one, you're going to leave the same amount of space. The last one, same amount of space. So we want to set spacing for all. And let's set this to unit centimeter. Aside from having this, let's go and I'll set item. Now this item, you can specify your item here dot text. So that is where you can put in your text. So this is the page text. You see, so we can have something like this. But well, one good thing about this is for demonstration purpose, QuestPDF also provides a placeholder. And now this placeholder is a dummy text. If you've worked with MS Word before, you know that you can generate a dummy text in there, right? The same thing has been added. The same feature has been added here, so we can also generate the same dummy text. So instead of me putting this over here, let's go and put something in there, which is automatically going to generate. So let's see, and we can say this is placeholders. As you can see from this, you know, it is coming from the helpers folder dot. Then we can talk about, we have this lorem. Now this will give us access to a dummy test, and then we can also go in for, so with this column we want to specify test image and a question. Maybe it could be that, so we're having three items in there. From every, within the spaces between each, you're going to have 1 centimeter each. As we then, let's also specify same item dot, this time round we can go for image, and placeholders also provides image. Let's specify the width and the height. So when you have your image, that is going to place it. Okay, you're going to remove the placeholders, placeholders, and then put your actual thing in there. Then the next one we have, let's also specify another test. And now with this test, we need same placeholders dot. We can also go for questions, which is going to give us a dummy question. Okay, so let's assume this is what we need. We are done. Now, once you have this, we need to go and also write our footer. So we have our page header, our page content, and now there's our footer. That is the last part. And we can align center, you can align bottom, we can align left, as alignment, you can do any. Then we can also say dot test. Now with the test, you can specify it here. So x dot, we can do span so it can be joined, and here we want to specify page number, and that is what normally we do. So, and here we're going to say that we have this, we can say x dot, then we can have current page number. So you see, that's the beauty of this package. It has everything that you need. All that you need to do here is to call it and now use it, and that is all. So we have this, and that is it. So this is what we need to create for our footer, right? We're going to have a page number beneath, and we're going to center that. Okay, so let's close up. Now this is our private method that we need to create. How do we use it here in our endpoint? It's also quite simple. Now within that, you know, this package is actually not for free, but it has a free community version for everybody, even a company, when your income does not exceed, is it $1 million? Okay, I think so. You can check the documentation, I'll find and put the link in there. But we have a community version that you can use for free. Okay, so that's what I'm going to be using this, and you can use this in your project. So let's have our, let's first register and tell the Quest API that, hey, this, you want to use community license. So license is equal to license type. You see, we have professional enterprise, but you want to focus on this community because it also works. Okay, then let's have our document. This document is going to come from the document that we have created, the private document that we have created. Is it method, not document? Yes. Now let's go and create or generate a PDF file. So we can see this document that we have, or this PDF file, this equal to document that we have created dot. You see, now we have not even PDF only, we have image, we have SVG, we have XPX, but we want to focus on this generate PDF. You can generate and show, but here we want to generate it only as a file. After we are done generating this, you know, since we have an action result, we can return file result. So return, instead of returning okay or a bad request, whatever, you want to return this file. Now passing this PDF file, that is a file, we need the content type, and it is application slash what PDF, isn't it? Aside from specifying the content type, we also need range processing, and here we can give it a name for this. You see, it's overloaded, right? So when you check it, we need this file download name. We need a content type. Content type. No, this is a file content itself, which is in byte array. We need a content type as string, which is application/PDF. Then we need a file download name. It could be NAS, as you can see from this, but well, we want to give this file a specific name. So if you want to do that, then put down an else. You can also skip it. Let's say this is Netcode-Hub. So it's going to be Netcode-Hub.PDF. Let's close that. And that is all. You can see, yeah, it's simple steps to do it. Now is the testing time. Let's see whether what I told you is same. Oh, you see that our API is running, but it hasn't launched in the browser because you forgot to do it, and you forgot to specify the launch URL for this. And this can be found in the solution properties, launch settings, go in there, and here default it is what, false. So kindly put this to true. You want to make sure it is true. Then let's specify our launch URL, and here let's say this is scalar/v1. So put in this and let's go again. Now watch it out. So you can see that we have our demo generate PDF opening, as you can see from here, and this is our endpoint PDF generator. Click on that, that is get. So if I click on test this out, let's see. Now we're going to send this. It is a get request. When you check our endpoint, that is exactly what we did. Now let's say click on send and see what's going to happen. Oh, amazing. I see that. Now we have our PDF, which has been launched and opened within our API doc, which is a scalar. And you know, when using Swagger, you need to click on download file before you can view it. But with the scalar, which is advanced, it has even launched and opened preview this for us to see what is going on. And that's amazing. So you have it over here. As you can see, we have this the page header. We set the color to blue medium. Do you remember? This dummy test, the lorem that we provided. And then we have an image placeholder. Then we have our question. Now take a look. We specify the spacing to be 1 centimeter each. So we see the same thing. Now if you check the space between here, if you measure it, you see we have the same thing. You can use measuring tape to do that. And then so the last one, that is our footer. We have a page one, which is the current page. Then we put it in the middle as we center that. You see, so we have it. Now, if you want to save this, you see download. So you can click on this and now click on download, which I've been downloaded with the name of Netcode-Hub. If I open in this, let's check it out. Oh, it's the same. If you check your folder, you have the same thing. You see, so that's the simplest, the easiest, and the professional way of integrating API, not an API, PDF in your API. If you want to have this in a practical example, let's say in a project, stay tuned because I'll actually prepare a project and then we see how we can integrate this, generate a nice PDF and view that in Blazor application. And I believe you're going to love that. Okay. All right. So if you like this, then do not forget to give this video a thumbs up. It's very important. Actually, it's how this video spread worldwide. And I believe you want to have this channel. So do not forget. If you haven't subscribed, it means you are missing something a lot. Then do not forget also to put your thumbs on that subscribe button to get subscribed. And also make sure you get notified all the time as soon as I upload new content. All right, stay tuned for more updates and the nice packages like this and how you can integrate them in your API to create a powerful and efficient app. All right, thank you, and I'll catch up again. Until then, take care.